All right. What do you think, Charles?
Okay, so I think a couple of things. Let me just sort of talk this out loud. So we're trying to learn incrementally. We're trying to figure out how, if we just kind of keep adding these random variables in sort of weighted way you described before, what we would end up at. So why do we want to choose alpha t with a particular kind of property? Well, if you look at it, it's clear that alpha t at each time step is moving closer and closer to zero. So it means you start out learning a lot, and you sort of believe things less and less and less, or you let things change you less and less and less over time. So what is that likely to end up at? Well, the first thing I noticed that, well, if it's going to do that, then it has to converge at some point. It just makes sense. So that helps me to eliminate the second answer. But actually, that also lets me eliminate the fourth answer, because in some ways, that says the same thing. So that leaves us with the expected value of x and the expected value of x squared, or the expected value of x squared, or whichever one it is that is variance. Okay, so I'm going to go with the expected value of x.
So the expected value of x, right. So it turns out that this is actually a way of computing the average by just, you know, repeatedly sampling and updating your values. And the way to think about it is that sometimes the x values that we draw are going to be a bit above the average, and it's going to pull the v value up. Sometimes it's a little bit below the average, and it's going to pull the value down. But in the limit, all those pulls and pushes are going to cancel out, and it's going to settle in on the actual average value, the expected value of this random variable.
Right, because in principle, you're going to see an infinite number of those things, and effectively all you're doing is adding them all up and then sort of, you know, well, you're effectively averaging them one little bit at a time.
Yeah, that's a good way to think about it. That in fact, it's adding them up and it's computing a weighted average. But the weights are these alphas, and the weights are decaying over time. So we're going to put more weight on the more recent ones, but some weight on the further away ones. But it sort of doesn't matter because the order, since we're drawing these IID, the order doesn't matter. And the thing that it has to converge to is the mean.
Right. I like it.
So let's relate that back to what we do in Q learning.